across town, Ben meets with a witness to tic-tac activity in the region who may have had a close encounter with gray aliens.
So, Katie, we've just kind of just started the investigation. I want to know what you've been doing recently and what you found.
Colorado has its fair share of unusual activity, especially cattle mutilations. There was a great little book that was written. It was actually research into, it's called The Choppers and the Choppers, because there were so many mutilations that were happening so frequently, and it just wasn't cattle either. It was sheep, horse. There's even reports of dog that were being mutilated.
So this got to be like, to a point where people were, they were very scared. Mm-hmm. They had vigilante groups that were armed and patrolling at night, because the three theories, right, were that, number one, that they were predatory natural deaths. Mm-hmm. The second one was that it was a cult of some sort,
right,
which is a really complex theory as well. And then the third being possible extraterrestrial.
Right. And there's a fourth there, actually, too. Our own military coming in and testing groundwater and taking and mutilating cattle themselves. But, you know, why would they do it in that particular way? Why would they just randomly scare the heck out of people? And that's always been a big question of mine. And I have found articles, you know, in the paper, like the theory and what to me points that it could be military involvement are these strange, unmarked, mysterious helicopters. Why are they out there, and why are they menacing people? And even young kids, I found articles, you know, helicopter menacing girls related to stock mutilations.
So, Katie, we've talked to someone who claims that they, you know, saw a fast-moving pill-shaped object, and then I talked to someone who believes that she's been abducted ever since she was about 2 years old, having experience with grays. Right now, I know that Colorado is a hot spot.
Well, yeah, Colorado for sure. I mean, we have a long history. Was this a witness that had experiences with the grays? Mm-hmm. Does she have that in Colorado here?
Yes.
Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah, you know, I've been researching a phenomenon that happened to me decades ago out in Elbert County, Colorado, on a ranch. It was known as the Clearview Ranch. It was the year 1977. It was a weekend night. Me and my older sister were hanging out with the three boys that lived on the ranch property. All of a sudden, this loud hum starts up. All the power goes out in the house. Out the window, big, bright, white light. No sound. It wasn't a helicopter. Brightest light I have ever seen in my life. All of a sudden, we heard this disembodied voice. And it came from every orifice of that ranch house. And it said, "We allowed you to remain. Your friends will be warned to keep silent concerning us." My mom was terrified. Get in the car. When I arrived home from that episode that night, I went paralyzed and I couldn't even talk. And I got my first really bad migraine headache that night. And I had severe migraine headaches after that.
Is it possible Kate experienced missing time and was even abducted?
This is the most disturbing thought for me, okay? We talked to a witness that claims that she's been abducted since she was 2. Mm-hmm. She was disturbed the fact she never gave consent.
Right.
And here again, we have you growing up, you know, visiting a ranch. You have this warning, this threat given to you that says, "We have allowed you to be here." Mm-hmm. Who gave them the right to tell you where you can live and what you can do? I have a problem with that. Mm-hmm. Somebody thinks they're in control, and somebody doesn't want their agenda to be known.
But Katie wasn't afraid to take matters into her own hands.
I joined MUFON in 2012 to look for answers for all the stuff that happened at that ranch at the time.
Katie became the go-to contact for strange encounters at Clearview Ranch. And over the past decade, she's heard of numerous sightings of tic-tac UFOs.
There were craft sightings.
One incident really grabbed her attention, a pair of fighter planes that collided in midair in 1975.
There were two interceptors that were flying out of Buckley. And in this document here, it says they were in pursuit of a UFO. And that the two interceptors crashed.
The pilots are dead?
No, they actually both lived. They both pulled their chutes and they lived. I actually FOIA'd Kirkland Air Force Base Mishaps Office. I got this big packet back, which was really interesting.
The file Katie acquired through the Freedom of Information Act was heavily redacted, but it did mention a UFO.
So you're saying in here, they're talking about a third craft.
Yeah, they're talking about that the pilot sees another craft.
The pilots describe the unknown craft as long and cylindrical in shape, closely matching contemporary descriptions of Tic Tac UFOs.
This is all like within the Clearview kind of area.
If that's not frightening enough, the concentration of UFO sightings in the sky correlates with another wave of disturbing activity on the ground.
Here in Elbert County, we had all sorts of cattle mutilations almost occurring daily. Not only cow, but also horse, sheep, and even dog.
So what are these ranchers reporting as far as the description of the mutilation?
Oftentimes, a lot of the blood is drained from the animal. Sometimes, you know, their tongue will be removed, their rectum will be removed, an ear, an eye, just certain things. They have these cuts that are like laser precision.
What is your opinion as to why they're looking for specific organs or why the blood is drained?
I don't know if it's for genetic purposes. I don't know if it has to do with a hybrid program. Who knows?
Well, that's the big puzzle, right? Are they using the ranches and livestock as a laboratory? I have no idea.
Tic Tacs above, animal mutilations below. The hallmarks of a hybridization program are present. Could ranches such as Clearview serve as a lab for Gray's intent on studying earthly life forms to create alien-human hybrids?
Mutilations happen in rural areas because it's less likely to be seen. Let's say you're the alien and you're trying to be covert about your operation. You don't want them to see them bringing back a bunch of dead cattle.
So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go back to talk to Melissa, my partner, and see if we can kind of put this together and actually get on the ranch. Please keep in touch with me, though.
Oh,
I know
absolutely.
A lot of calls are coming in, and we got a lot more to do.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I'm just seeking answers like everybody else.
There seems to be some patterns emerging here. The cattle mutilations, with the degree they're described and the entities that witnesses are saying are in the same locale, is very interesting to me. Katie really got me excited about getting out.
The Grays, they're extremely intelligent. They're almost machine-like. They're so scientific in their approach. They're basically studying these animals.
Could the Grays be studying cattle as a gateway to understanding earthly life forms? If cattle mutilations are indeed step one in the Gray hybridization program, then ranches like Clearview could be the key to exposing their nefarious plans.